Hello everyone, my name is Jimmy Barrera. I'm a SolidWorks Elite Application Engineer and I work for Cimquest. And today I'm going to be showing you what's called the exhaust recirculation demo or vignette. And basically it's to show you some fluid flow capabilities of SolidWorks flow simulation. So this is what we have here. We have the yellow component, which represents the fresh air coming through the system. We have a gray component, which represents the exhaust gas recirculation. And we have a couple of things set up here. To start, we have everything capped off with lids. This allows us to do an internal flow simulation test. So we have here the inlet air. This represents the airflow coming into the intake system at 50 grams per second at 40 degrees Celsius. We also have the exhaust gas flowing into the system through this gray pipe, and that's coming in at 9 grams per second, 280 degrees Celsius, and we have the concentration set at 100% exhaust gas. So then the outlet here, we have a lid, and that represents the atmospheric pressure. So the question is, how well is this system able to mix the two gases coming through the system? What's the mixing efficiency? Well, we do have different ways of determining that through SolidWorks flow simulation. Notice here that we have a couple of goals set up, global goals and surface goals that have to do with the pressure drop in the pipes, the exiting volume flow rate, the velocity. As far as the outlet mixing efficiency, we have a couple of surface goals determined here as a mass fraction, and that's going to be reading the information as it comes out of the system there. So we've already ran these tests. So let's look at some of the powerful ways that flow simulation has to interrogate your results. To start, we have what's called the section plot. And if I turn on the section plot here, it allows me to dynamically move the section through the assembly. So as I move this point, notice that it's giving me an updated flow of what's going on inside the system here. Very easy to manipulate. So let me put it back to where it was. And another nice thing about this section plot is as I zoom in to the section over here where you see recirculation, the streamlines update and they give you a more accurate and granular result there. So you can see what's going on. Obviously, you have some recirculation going on there. Let's go back to our previous view. Okay, so I'm going to take this guy off. Another way to analyze your results are ISO surfaces. Turn that on. And notice that this one is set out for a mass fraction of exhaust gas. Now, if I go ahead and edit the definition of this, I can move the value and I can see where that value occurs throughout my model. As I can see here, the higher concentration of exhaust gas is occurring down in the back here where the recirculation occurs. Let me show you a third way of analyzing your results here. These are called surface plots. Now, surface plots can be created on all or a portion of the model. In this case, I created a surface plot for the whole internal part of the model. So I can really see what's going on when I turn this on. Again, I have this set out for mass fraction of exhaust gas. And as the other two plots show, the exhaust gas is staying towards the bottom portion of this model. Not really mixing too well. And the last way I'm going to show you that we can interrogate the results here of the flow simulation, it's using flow trajectories. This is really cool. I'm going to show the exhaust side of it. And we can see here, if I were to play this, how the exhaust is moving through the system. I want to play the air side of it. We can see how both of them are flowing and mixing throughout the system. Interesting enough, as you can see, the air is staying towards the top of the assembly here, towards the top of the pipe, while the exhaust gas is staying towards the bottom of the pipe. They're not really mixing well, as we confirm with the other three studies. So what are we going to do at this point? Let me go ahead and stop these guys, turn these off. What we're going to do at this point is we have two more different configurations or variations of this project. Here we have the extended exhaust. As you can see, this comes up just a little bit. And then we have the turned exhaust. So the question is, which configuration will give us the maximum mixing efficiency? Well, the nice thing about SolidWorks flow simulation is that we can determine all these things and set up all these scenarios and get our results to get the best design possible during the design process. So in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to focus in on the outlet portion of it. What this is going to allow me to do is it allows me to see how well the gas is mixing as it exits the system. Right there, where it's out of the way. So I'm going to use a nice feature here called compare, and it'll allow me to compare the results among the three various configurations. While it's doing this, notice that it's taking the active scene, it's taking the surface parameters I have showing there and the goal plot. It's not only going to output numbers for me, but it's also going to show me pictures of what the results are among the three different configurations. It's a great time saver. Okay, now that it's done, we can go to the first one, the active scene. Now I can compare the results at the outlet of the mass fraction of the exhaust. This is showing the default configuration. If I go to my next one, notice that this one mixes really well. This is the extended configuration. And then we have our turned configuration. I'd like to point out that the difference between the default, where the concentration of the exhaust gas is on this side, by changing the configuration to the turned, notice that it solves it over here, but now the problem is in a different area. So it gives you a nice visual feedback of what's going on. Let's check out the other tabs. We also have a surface parameter, and the numbers confirm our results right now. We have a mass fraction of the exhaust maximum value. Notice the lowest maximum value is in the extended configuration, as we saw in the picture. And last, we have our goal plot, which takes the average mass fraction of the exhaust gas, and the lowest value is the extended exhaust at the outlet. This is what SolidWorks simulation does really well. So I hope you enjoy the exhaust recirculation demo. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us at Cimquest. We'll be glad to help you out and answer any questions you have. Till next time, take care.